Hello everyone! This time you can watch me use the acrylic bloom technique on MDF coasters. I'm going to use some nice Christmas colors and also again an experiment with using my mica pigments in an untinted base paint, so I'm very curious and I hope you enjoy watching the process and give me a thumbs up for it. So yeah, I'm going to make 4 coasters. You will see the whole process of me make the bloom on top of the wooden or the MDF coasters, but also adding a resin layer on top of the acrylic paint. And I'm going to use some nice Christmas colors in the colors red, gold and green. And I mix them in an untinted base paint. I already started with the first coaster. First I poured a white base layer and on top the puddles of the colors that I'm using. And of course I'm using a cell activator. And then I try to blow that cell activator on top of those colors and create that nice lacing effect. And I got a lot of questions about my pouring medium, but I'm still testing it. So when I'm satisfied, then I'm going to tell you all which untinted base paint I'm using, because I don't have any secrets, as you know, but first I want to test it and make sure that it's a good pouring medium. Otherwise you will spend a lot of money on a pouring medium that isn't working that well. But so far the first coaster looks great. There you can see it. Some nice lacing. And I'm also searching for another cell activator, because here in the Netherlands we can't buy the Australian Flutrol anymore, so I need to search for something else that is easy to use but also cheap to buy. But now I'm using the Australian Flutrol, so some nice lacing effects already, and I'm making sure that I pour enough paint off, because otherwise the paint will crack during drying. So I'm starting with the second one. First a white base layer, and I'm using 2 different paints, wall paints. I'm using a latex satin paint and a normal regular wall paint. I will add the link in the description below this video. And I use 300 gram of one and 300 gram of the other, and then I added 70 gram of water. On top, the Aurora Gold. It's a mica pigment. It's one of my own mica pigments. Then on top, the Golden Interference Bright Gold. Very nice color. And then on top, an experiment. It's one of my mica pigments. It's the Twinkling Forest. And it has a little bit of a larger particle size, so I hope it will work. And then on top, also a new color that I'm testing. It's the Sassy Red, and it's a fluorescent color, so hopefully it will give me a nice shine. And then on top of that, the cell activator. So at the end, I'm going to show you how the Sassy Red lights up if I use a UV lamp. So if you're curious, then you can wait until the end. So now I'm blowing again the cell activator on top of those colors. There you can see it. And already I'm getting some nice lacing effects. And the first one looks great. But yeah, it's a very difficult technique, I think. And it all depends on the right mix, the right consistency, and the right paints. Again, I'm tilting those enough paint off my coaster. And I'm also working on a video in which I show how I mix the paints and the cell activator. But that is for upcoming video. And then I'm also going to try to show you what the consistencies are of my paints and cell activator, because I'm using different paints. I'm using mica pigments, fluid acrylics, but also tube paints. And it all is has a different mix. Also, that one looks great. On to the third one. So first, the white base layer. And these coasters are about 10 centimeters, so large enough. That is also a color from DecoArt. It's the fluid green gold, very nice color. On top, the twinkling forest, a mica pigment. Then the Aurora gold, also a mica pigment. And this is the DecoArt metallic in the color ruby. And then another mica pigment, and that's the sassy red again. And then the interference bright gold from Golden. And then on top, the cell activator. And how I mix my cell activator: 3 parts Australian Flutrol and 1 part Amsterdam titanium white. And then I blow in the middle, not too hard. And when I blow harder, I lift my head and blow to the sides to try to blow that cell activator on top of those colors and hopefully create some nice lacing. But so far the first two coasters look great. Some nice lacing effects. And for my pouring medium, I used an untinted wood gel and Jo Sonja's gloss varnish. So the wood gel that I'm testing, so that's an experiment to see if it's working or not. Now the last one, again the white base layer. And the pouring medium is 3 parts wood gel and 1 part Jo Sonja's gloss varnish. And that's the pouring medium. For the mica pigments, I dispersed those mica pigments first in Jo Sonja's with some water to make those pigments wet. And then I've added 28 gram of the pouring medium. And that was my mix. For the fluid acrylics, I added 28 gram of pouring medium and 10 drops of the fluid acrylics, and that was the mix. And for the tube paints, like the DecoArt Ruby, I've added 28 gram of pouring medium and 2 gram of the tube paint. And then I added a little bit of Jo Sonja's to make it the same consistency as the other paints. Just like warm honey. But in an upcoming video, I'm going to show you how I mix my paints, if the wood gel is a success. Because in different countries there are different supplies used by, to make the pouring medium. And it's very difficult for us in the Netherlands here to buy the same products that is used in the USA or Australia. So I'm searching for another pouring medium that's also working and that is easy to use. So not that much supplies to use to make your pouring medium. And also I'm searching for a cheap one. So now again I'm tilting as much paint of my MDF coaster as possible, because if you leave too much on your surface then the paint will crack. So I'm done. I will leave this to dry and then I will show you how I add a resin layer. So this is a close-up right after pouring. Some nice lacing effects, there you can see it. But what I already can see is that the twinkling forest, what I told you with a larger particle size, doesn't work that well because it gets a little bit grainy. But the other colors look great. Also the sassy red, I'm very curious how it looks under a UV lamp because it's a fluorescent color. So it should light up, but we will find out. But so far the coasters look great. There you can see the twinkling forest, the dark green color, a little bit grainy. But yeah, it's also experimenting with different supplies and show it to you all. But so far I'm very pleased. Hopefully it will stay this way. So we are a week later and the acrylic paint is dry and now I'm going to add a resin layer. I'm using the Heat Pro resin from the Resin Pro company. It's a new formulated heat resistant resin. It's heat resistant up to 250 degrees, so that's good enough to place your hot coffee or tea on it. And so you can see I have a lot of air bubbles in my resin because it's very cold here, but that's no problem. I'm going to try to remove them with my heat gun and with my torch. And so you can see the lacing state very nice, and what I already mentioned, the twinkling forest with a larger particle size of mica got a little bit grainy, but it is not disturbing, it's still nice. So what I always do, I start in the middle with the resin and then I'm spreading it to the outside. I also taped the other side with some masking tape to, after the resin is dry, I can remove those drips much easier. And I think they look great. The lacing is very nice. It stayed, so that's good. So far, the wood gel is working. But I'm going to do some more experiments. And if I'm satisfied, I'm going to show you all how I mix it. So there I'm using my heat gun to remove those air bubbles. And it's working. And the torch, and then I'm almost done again working on the sides, and then I will show you all a close-up, the end result, but also I'm going to try to show you these coasters below a UV lamp to show you the fluorescent sassy red. So we are 24 hours later. Now I'm going to show you how the Sazerac lights up under a UV lamp, and it's amazing. Such a nice pigment, and it's one of my new pigments that still need to be added to my Etsy shop, but I'm very pleased with it. So let me know what you think. I think it looks amazing. And this is outside in the daylight, also very nice. The Sazerac also looks great in daylight, so that's good. The lacing looks amazing. There you can see it. So all the supplies I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, also below this video in the description with the links to the websites. And there is a lot of information in the description box. Also the link to my own Facebook group. So if you use my Just Paint supplies, please come and join me in my Facebook group and show me what you create with my supplies. I'm very curious. The link to my Etsy shop is in the description box where you can buy my Just Paint supplies. And also the link to my associates at Etsy shop, Evelyn Shaver. And she sells the mica pigments also for the people in the USA and Canada. So that's great. But I'm very pleased with this experiment. So let me know what you think of my coasters in nice Christmas colors. Hopefully you liked this video and give me a thumbs up for it. And I will see you all in my next video. Bye.